Going on, guys, and today I wanted to talk about Ben Simmons and James Harden. So Daryl Morey is hell-bent on trading Ben Simmons for James Harden. So let's get right into today's video. I want to hear your thoughts down below. What is your package for this? I know I've discussed this a lot, but hey, sixth video of the day. If you guys want to subscribe, leave a like. I upload at least 3 videos a day, about 100 videos a month. So let's get right into it and talk about Ben Simmons and Daryl Morey and James Harden. It's weird, guys. Let me hear those thoughts in the comment section. Let go. So this is all coming from The Athletic, Sam Amick, you know, John Hollinger, and Alex Sheffer. So let's get into it. So sources close to Ben Simmons have insisted for quite some time now that Daryl Morey is hell-bent on finding a way to bring James Harden to Philadelphia. I'm not surprised. He nearly did it on January 13th, 2021, when Rockets owner Tilman Fertitta asked Harden to choose his destination, Brooklyn or Philly, and was relieved when he chose the Nets. The Rockets, whose sources say, made it clear to Harden that they would welcome him back in Houston if that was ever in the cards, were operating like a player-friendly operation in their handling of a deal, but had all sorts of incentives to push the deal in Brooklyn's direction. Harden isn't expansive with the media when it comes to conflict and was short in his post-game press conference after the Sacramento game. While Harden has thrown hints that he's not crazy about Kyrie Irving playing part-time, a source with knowledge of Harden's thinking said he's frustrated in general with his Brooklyn Nets tenure. He came to Brooklyn expecting to be part of a three-headed monster, yet he has played a similar role to what was required of him in the Houston, having to be that guy, especially now with Kevin Durant out. While Irving's part-time status is unprecedented, a source aware of the team's thinking said the 6'2" point guard situation hasn't been much of a problem as one would expect because he's played hard when available, albeit in a limited capacity. All right. So when we sit here, what is the deal? Because there's also rumors coming out that Philadelphia isn't willing to give up Seth Curry, Matthias Thybulle, and Shake Milton. Brooklyn's over here thinking like, we're about to get a big old package for James. And, you sit here and you're like, well, Brooklyn wants guys. And they want to get rid of Ben Simmons, the Sixers. So when you look at this, Ben Simmons, $33 million. James Harden this year, it's interesting because a James Harden trade, okay, I think would make things... It would be difficult, okay? And especially with, I don't know what package, what a Ben Simmons, James Harden trade specifically should look like. And why is this happening? I mean, it's interesting. So, what's next? We got, 6 days to figure out how to do this. And people have insisted that, let's make a deal. What is this looking like? Because his max deal, if he tacked on the 4-year extension this summer, is $275 million for James Harden. He'll be 38 years old. Basically by the time he gets off that deal. So when you're looking at that, the Sixers will argue they're sending a 25-year-old all-star to Brooklyn who signed for 4 years in exchange for an older player who wants out and can leave after the season. The Nets will argue they're throwing the Sixers a lifeline after Simmons didn't have nearly the market value they originally hoped, and Harden is one who actually made the all-star team this year. So they could go back and forth over this. And the other aspect is the luxury tax. Brooklyn could potentially save a lot of money on the Harden-Simmons trade, and they would save about $40 million in salary and luxury tax payments. And the Sixers would obviously add a luxury tax penalty if they did this. So a trade of Ben Simmons and Danny Green for Harden would be pretty close to a neutral financially. Virtually any other plausible combo saves the Nets a ton of money and would leave Philadelphia basically haggling on assets and prospects. Finally, that's what I think. And I think it's interesting because some people could argue that, look, if Harden does go to Philadelphia, given all the Nets pick he owns, Houston owns all the Nets pick. So if Harden goes to Philadelphia, it's interesting though, because the Nets are getting a young, talented player with a high ceiling in Ben Simmons, but they could also maybe get Tyrese Maxey, who's also another guy with a high ceiling, so which would extend their championship window for the Nets and give them another score alongside Kevin Durant. Seth Curry and Danny Green could give the Nets some much needed scoring, especially Danny Green with some defense as well, with Joe Harris having a bunch of uncertainty with his second procedure needed. And Matthijs Thybulle's defense is a much needed for a unit that has ranked in the NBA cellar in the last few games. And any first round pick is better than none. The Nets can upgrade their supporting cast mildly and get younger, two things that were rather unlikely in a deal without a big asset. So we'll either see a deal that's Ben Simmons and Danny Green for, and maybe some picks for James Harden, or we could see a deal that's Ben Simmons with a combination of maybe Danny Green, Seth Curry, and potentially maybe either Matthijs Thybulle or Tyrese Maxey. Those are really what it's looking like, and that's where I want to hear your thoughts down below. That's basically the video, guys. Until next time, guys, put peace out.